Okay, so this is Ember's compost pile after almost a week. See if I can put you up here and still be able to see. Okay. So when you turn a compost pile, you want to pull it apart. When you pull it apart, you want to go in and flip it. Get the wet stuff from the bottom to come up onto the top. But at the same time, not make a mess. Every time you turn it, you want to reshape it into a nicer, tighter pile. That's a worm. You want to hold the worm? Which is at the bottom, up on the top, and put the stuff that's not as decomposed at the bottom because it'll decompose faster that way.
you need to get the pitchfork in here now. I know you absolutely love helping me with this. Snipping them down helps them to decompose and not tangle. Trying to work with tangled vines and branches. So, do a little bit of that. And get it all back up on top. And then we're done. Bigger stuff at the bottom of the pile if you're not planning on breaking it down. Jump in this pile. This is all wet. Excuse me.
Mama's gotta get in here.
Yep. Hold on, Mama's almost done. Sweetie, where's Papa? Poppy. And that is how you turn a compost pile. Nothing to it. It moves slightly from where it was originally, however, that's part of the game. In there, that's a straw.
much nicer pile than before. And that is one dirty child playing in the dirt.
Now, while I have you here,
I want to show you the strawberries. They've been putting runners out all over the place. And every chance, these are the wild ones, I don't know if they're edible. However, every chance I get, I redirect the runners. So now, I have strawberries growing in every pocket on this planter. Although I'm not letting these run into any other ones, and I might pull it up if it's not what I think it is. If it has yellow flowers, it's poisonous, and it's coming up. If not, I'm gonna let it make a strawberry and try it, see if I like it. The potatoes are starting to grow back from when I cut the blight off of them. However, there are still some spots with blight. There's some very good potatoes coming up in the center, and then these ones off to the side. Pepper is getting big. That pepper's actually got some more leaves. Garlic's doing good. Cabbage still isn't doing anything, but it hasn't died yet. This cabbage is starting to grow phenomenally. We've got the two tomatoes still on this. However, this tomato has a black hole in it. So something crawled in there, and we won't be eating that tomato. But this one has a flower. You want to make sure that your plants are pollinated. Take your finger and go jiggle, 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 and pollinate it yourself.
Bye.
I still do not know if this is a plant or a weed, but it's staying there. And these strawberries, I found out weren't doing too well because I didn't plant them deep enough. Parts of the roots were still showing out through the soil. So I put a little bit of worm castings that I scooped off of one of those bricks over there into there to cover them up. And now this is the stony drain thing that leads up to a patch of concrete where I was going to plant stuff. So, what I'm most likely going to do is put a couple planters here. Because underneath this window, I'm going to be planting some pollinators. I've got a pinkish red and white honeysuckle, and a blue, yes, blue and white lily of the valley coming in. I'm going to plant them in a planter and probably put a trellis up. This way, the smell pretty goes into the house, but it also will attract the pollinators and bring them closer to the vegetables.